This is Tara from Stranded by the Sea, and I'm going to be demonstrating for you how to perform the knit front, back stitch, which you may see abbreviated as KFBFB. The knit front, back stitch is a triple increase, and that means that we are adding three stitches into the stitch that we are working. I'm going to show you how to perform that continental style, and then I will also show you how to do it English style. So to begin, we take our working needle and insert it into the front of the stitch like you would normally for a knit stitch. Pull that yarn through, but we're going to leave the stitch that we're working on our left-hand needle. Then we bring our working needle around to the back side of our work and insert that through the back loop of the stitch. Then we are going to knit through the back loop. And when we've done that, our working needle is again out to the front. We need to insert that around the front leg of the stitch and out the back as if we are knitting, and knit the stitch, still leaving that stitch that we are working on the left-hand needle. And then for the last time, bring your working needle to the back side and insert that through the back loop of the stitch. It might be getting quite tight at this point, so you might need to wiggle it in there. You may also only be able to get the tapered part of your needle through the stitch. That's fine. As long as you can knit one more time through the back loop, you're going to be just fine. And there we have a knit front, and back, and we have completed our triple increase. I'm going to knit for a few stitches just to give us some space, and I will show you again how to knit that as if you are working English style. So to perform the knit front, back English style, we are going to insert our needle from the front to the back as if to knit and wrap our yarn, pulling a knit stitch through but leaving the stitch that we are working on the left-hand needle. Bring our working needle around to the back and insert that through the back loop. Wrap and pull a knit stitch through the back loop. Our working needle is again in front. Wrap that around the front leg and out the back as if to knit. Wrap and pull our knit stitch through. Last time, we're still leaving that working stitch on the left-hand needle. And insert our working needle through the back leg of that stitch that we are working. Again, that can get kind of tight. As long as you can wrap and pull a stitch through the back loop, you can work that on the very tips and tapered part of your needle if you need to. And there we have the increase again. I'm going to just knit to the row and show you what that increase looks like after you have finished the row and when it's laying down underneath your working needle. There's the end of our row. And there is our increase stitch right there. We have a nice little cluster of four stitches coming out of that one stitch that we have worked. We have the first stitch that is knit. The second stitch was through the back loop. So this has the familiar look of a knit front and back. It has a little purl bump at the bottom. And then we have another pair. It looks as if we've almost done two knit front and backs right next to each other. So we have again another knit stitch and then a purl bump for that last time through the back loop. I hope this was helpful and I hope that you enjoyed it.